Alright, so I'm painting one of my bass swim baits that I make. If you guys would like to see a separate video on making one of those, glide bait, crank down like this one, or a multi-jointed swim bait, let me know down in the comments. Please like and subscribe, it really helps you know what kind of content you guys are wanting to see. And I also do some whopper ploppers. It's kind of hard to get a good, there, you can see it a little better. Alright, this is going to be a little longer video. I'm going to start with white, I'm going to wipe the bait out, just normal white. I have paint in these little containers here to thin them out. There. Sometimes it gets dried on the ends of them if you leave them open. Okay. I'm running about 20 psi right here. Okay. And I need to clean it. I can raise the pressure a little bit. For just whiting out a bait, you really don't have to worry a whole lot about. You don't have to worry at all about being very detailed. It's spraying, okay. There we go, that's what's going on. And this thing's a little heavy for this stand. It is way too heavy for this stand to be moving it around, but that's all I got. Have a second. Alright, I did the white, now I'm gonna do pearl white. That didn't work. I didn't think it would. Alright. Just the way it was angled, I didn't think it would work. Probably fall over. forgot about this color. Second. Coming together a little bit. It's getting there. Yeah, I'll be able to have that. I'll blend that in. That looks good. Still got quite a bit of white going there. Okay. That's what I forgot about. Okay, hold on. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that looks good. Needs a couple spots where it's darker. If you look at a bass, I mean, it really isn't very many, but you look at a bass and it's got all these little bitty tiny dark spots in it throughout the scales. I think that looks pretty good. Now to this side. And it's almost random, really. There. That looks pretty good. It's got a little bit of scale pattern throughout it. There and there. It's looking good. Yeah, it's a little more. That's better. And truly fast, they really are. They're lighter, but they actually have a darker look to them because the little spots on their scales. If you look at it, it's not really just lighter. I gotta make sure it's getting it. It's not really just lighter. There's more dark spots throughout it. All over. I mean, there's the pattern. So you got all these little dark spots all over the place. And there's all sorts of markings and everything, and I feel like this kind of encompasses it as close as I can get it for the moment. And this is using a black gold. Once I put a clear coat on that, it'll really change. It really is just black mixed with gold. to however you think it would be best. I'm using a pearl copper. You can also use a gold for this. Basically, it's pretty much the same. It seems like French form. Need a little something to change that up here. Just try to change it up a little. Right, that's what I did. And I'm sure there's gonna be somebody that doesn't quite think that. Oh, that's right. I forgot I had that color too. It got thrown away.
He absolutely knew it. I've seen that documentary where they talk about the breakup of the Birds. And then he gets kicked out of the Birds. He was on the first five albums with the Birds. And, you know, break him when they kicked him out.
And it's just a little something. I'll go right away. Just up to the head. I used to have a really light blue, and it was perfect. But I'm pretty sure that's going to work. I know you're probably thinking, nah, that's no good. But, I have this swimbait right here, this crank down. It's got a little bit of blue on it. And I promise you, I've caught bass, big bass. They'll hit this bait and hit this bait and hit this bait from the bottom. And, I mean, I know I need to upsize those hooks are kind of small on it. That's part of why they end up hitting it and not getting hooked, but they'll hit it and hit it and hit it and hit it from the bottom by the hooks. And if they don't get hooked, they'll keep coming back, and I can work it. I can just cast out there, twitch it once, and if they're still out there, they'll come back and hit it. But I swear that blue gives them kind of a target, and this is going to be a fast moving bait. So if that blue is up here and they're hitting at it, that hook's right about there. It's gonna be right in their line of getting them. And it would look better here than it would back there. I've actually seen a couple bass, and it's not even really much of a blue. It'd be like the least amount of blue for almost the most amount of pearl white you can get. It's just a tiny bit of blue. Or a tiny bit of something. It's just not pure pearl white with the, some of the smaller bass. That, like, if you catch a little one, you just try to catch a little one. From my experience, a couple of them that I've seen, all it is just not pearl white. That's it. Or not. Not a white. Alright, sorry, I used a heat gun. Get that off my brain. A little bit of pearl white. I think that's it. And then the eyes. That looks good. Get the other side. Nah. That's okay. That looks good. Yeah, that looks really good. And that blue, all it is just something to break it up. It'll look a little different with clear coat on it anyway. Oh, one last thing. If you do like this content, please let me know, because I can do more. I can do bluegill bass. Shad's kind of tricky. But if swim baits are more what the majority of you guys, you guys are looking for, let me know and I can do more of it.